What up? Welcome to CK on the World. We are on our way to New Brunswick. I just made it to Montreal. Pierre Elliott Trudeau Airport. First time in Quebec. But yeah, I'm on my way to New Brunswick, St. John's. It's raining. Motherfucker, it's raining outside. It's raining pretty hot. But I gotta go look for my connection. I got about an hour or so layover. This is the French part of Canada, if you don't know. Everybody's still wearing masks. But this is the French part of Canada. Come check it out. Welcome to Chowkyo on the World. Look where I am. I'm on the East Coast, man. It's Maritimes, New Brunswick. Finally made it. Landed at 11 o'clock. Man, it's only an hour to midnight. I started this journey at 12 Alberta time. We've lost about 3 hours coming to the East Coast. It's my first trip down to Maritimes. Hope you guys are gonna have fun. I'm gonna enjoy this adventure. Got my backpack on.
Well, good Monday morning. Got off the plane in St. John, New Brunswick. Just so you know, there's two St. John in Canada. There's one St. John's, Newfoundland with an S, and then there's one St. John, spelled actually Saint, for New Brunswick. But I made it here last night at about 1 o'clock. The time change is brutal, wow. 3 hours time change from Western Canada to Eastern Canada. I didn't expect how brutal it is. I'm pretty tired. But I got here last night. There was nothing really open to eat. I was so hungry. The only thing I could get was a 24-hour McDonald's. And that was all right. I mean, McDonald's late night, you know, open for the bar. But I was hoping to grab something. But there was really nothing to do. Last night when I got in, I couldn't even go out and have a beer. But I tried to get some good sleep last night. The neighbor was being pretty loud. And then all of a sudden, at about 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock here, there goes my alarm. I hear banging. And guess who's banging? And guess who's banging out there? Let me just show you guys. Yeah. There we go, we got some construction workers over there building a new building, and that hence is the banging. So to try to get a good night's sleep, I had a good night's sleep except for the neighbor. I didn't get to bed till like 3 o'clock mountain time, which is like 12 o'clock midnight Alberta time typically is when I'm in bed anyway. But I ended up staying at the Hilton Gardens. It's right on Main Street, or just off of Main Street on Moncton. From my location here, it seems to be like central downtown. I still gotta get on Google Maps and try to situate myself. But I did take a little drive yesterday down into the little bar district on Main Street. I guess if you get on Main Street and you head and it goes into Dieppe. But yeah, I'm gonna do a little bit of exploring today. But first off, I'd have a little more of a nap, maybe half hours, get a haircut, get some breakfast, and then we'll explore Moncton. And then hopefully I get to see my wife later. That'll be good.
Well, I'm out leaving the hotel. I gotta get a haircut, man. So I'm actually in town here. I'm headed south to St. Andrews, New Brunswick. I got a convention for work that I'm supposed to be at, but I couldn't get a flight for my wife to come on the same flight. It was very expensive. They wanted $2,200 to match our flight. So I figured I'd just drive up to Moncton, pick her up, save myself $1,000, you know. So just a little fun fact here, you know. I did not know this after living in Canada for 30 years, but New Brunswick actually is the only official and the only true bilingual province in Canada. There is a true essence of bilingualism here. I mean, people here in the southern part of New Brunswick, central and southern, would be speak predominantly English, whereas the northeast coast, and from Moncton by the name, you could tell, are Acadian French. Now, this is very cool. I'm just driving around Main Street. It is a seaside town or a seaside city. If you head up a little bit northern, you'll hit a town called Shediac. Everybody keeps telling me I have to go there. Apparently, it's beautiful in that town, which I will be showing you guys later. But Moncton here has got a kind of like a nice, you know, Vancouver-esque feel. It's a harbor. There's an ocean close by. The ocean, you can smell it, you know. But it's very nice. As far as my first impressions, I feel very connected here. For some reason, it looks great. Ooh, look, there's a lobster place. It's called the Lobster Bar. I'm gonna have to be taking my wife there when she gets here, I think. We're gonna get her some lobster in her belly. But yeah, right now I just gotta go get a haircut, man. I couldn't sit around and wait anymore. It was a crazy night, man. My neighbor at my hotel, I don't know what the heck these guys were doing. They must have been out partying and then continued on the party. But all I heard last night was kick, 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 kick. And then I had just fallen asleep just past 3:30, and that was tough to do because of the time change. And then here this guy and his friends are just giving her. I didn't really say much, so I just left it. And then again at 4 o'clock they woke me up, and then 5, and then finally I had to call the front desk to deal with it. I mean, it was too much. And then of course again, you know, it's 7:30, all I hear is bang 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 bang, and the construction on the road is going nuts. So that didn't really help me out. So just a couple of tips for you travelers, you know. There is, I didn't bring any toothpaste, but most hotels, you know, they have some. So you could always call down to the front desk and say, hey, look, I forgot some toiletries. Can you guys bring me some? They will provide you a toothbrush, toothpaste, you know, just the essentials, right? So that's a good little tip. I actually learned that, you know, maybe about 4 years ago. So I never travel with anything, just my clothes. And I mean, the experience of traveling in Asia and in South America and into a little bit of Africa, I mean, they provide everything. In most hotels, meters, turn left. In these places, except the only places that don't really provide anything is North American hotels. And I don't know why, is we pay, you know, we pay out of the yin yang. I mean, the Hilton Gardens where I stayed is $220 a night. So, you know, and I forgot. There's another crazy thing. After living in Alberta for 21 years or so, that there's provincial tax here too. So just be aware when you do come to New Brunswick or any province outside of Alberta, there's two taxes. So there's a GST and then there's a PST, which is the provincial tax. So it comes out to about maybe 15% depending on what province you go to. Some provinces are lower, some provinces are a little bit higher than that. But, you know, just be aware, mostly, okay? Gas prices here, not too bad. $1.85. I was expecting a little bit over $2. But hey, I'll take $1.85, you know what I mean? It's not bad. So, but I really feel connected here for some reason. I feel like everybody I talk to seems so friendly so far, but you know, let's see how it goes here onto the trip as I make my way to different parts of New Brunswick. I'm very excited here that we are going to be headed down to St. John once I grab my wife, and then we're going to go to a town called St. Andrews. Typically, it's known by St. Andrews by the Sea. Very famous town. It's actually, and I'm going to be staying at the Algonquin Hotel. This is a hotel actually where Princess Diana and Prince Charles that stayed back in the 80s when they did their tour of Canada, paid by the Canadian taxpayers, just to let you know, these rich guys, these rich people traveling around, it's all paid by us. But yeah, that's another topic for a discussion later, but I'm gonna go get my hair cut. Let's check it out.
Your destination is on the right.
I found this place on Google, and like all the barber shops here don't open till Tuesday, and today's Monday, and I gotta look fresh for my convention. So let's see if this lady can help me out, get a nice little clip first off. So yeah, it's called Halftime. Let's see if this Halftime will give me a haircut, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, this place here, Sports Rocks, that was recommended to me by somebody yesterday, last night when I got in looking for food, but they were already closed by the time I got here. So yeah, but it looks like they got some good wings, very popular from what the guy told me here. Check this place out. That's where we're headed. We're going to Halftime. Let's see if this lady will come in and give me a haircut. Well, Halftime didn't work out, but I got a place called Fresh Cuts. She's ready to give me at 10 o'clock, so I'll be back. I'm gonna go check out the town. This looks like a place called Dieppe. So Moncton is over there, Dieppe is over here, off on Main Street. Shit, they got everything here. Look, Deluxe's French fish and chips. You know I'm gonna go check that place out. I'm here to eat the seafood, but y'all, I'm kind of getting excited here. But it is cloudy today, man. I got my fresh kicks on that my wife bought me. Look how fresh they are. Now I gotta go look for some waterproofing, you know? This thing got this guy all crazy here. But you can see the Acadian flags on lots of the cars around here. So Moncton is like a split between English and French. The Acadian French, right? You know, the Acadian French actually, what's the crazy story is, half of them ran from here when they first came from France, and they ran all the way down to Louisiana. They got chased. So, you know, that's pretty cool. That's a great history. So the Cajuns are actually Acadians that lived in Canada. And the other thing too is around this time of the year, if you head up towards the Acadian part, like from Moncton all the way up, in and around to, I have lots of friends up at Dieppe, Beaucaraquette, Miramichi, Bathurst. So August, around this time, is when they have an Acadian festival that comes in. So the Acadians from America, their cousins and family come up all the way to Beaucaraquette and Caraquette, and then they have a big Acadian fest. There's about 50 to 60,000 Acadians coming out to the festival. I'm gonna be sad to miss that. Unless I hit the Lotto Max, I would go there, right? You know, but unfortunately I could not get time to hang out to see that festival. But I still want to come back this way. This is my first dip into the Maritimes of Canada, and it surely won't be my last. So but breakfast, so haircut, breakfast, shower, jump in my car, check out the town, which is a little bit gloomy today. I gotta go check out Chinatown. Of course, you know, if I decide to move down here, I gotta know where to get my food. So for sure, I'm gonna be checking out Chinatown. Then we're gonna have to have a look for a local food spot. I seen one back by my hotel. We're gonna have to do a little bit of a review on the food on the East Coast, all right? So yeah.
Falls?
Yeah.
Dope,
no.
Town, Boys Town.
No, I haven't been. No. Where's that at?
It's up off the Miramichi. So above Miramichi, head towards Fredericton.
Okay, yeah, because I'm going to go head down. I'm just up here, pick up my friend coming in here, my wife. Because I flew into St. John last night, but it was very expensive to fly them there.
Okay.
So they wanted like $2,200 a person. It's cheap, easier to come up here and pick them up.
Well, like I say, if you enjoy waterfalls, Fallbrook Falls, it's 103 feet.
Okay.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Thank you.
And easy to get to. Like, it's only probably a 10-minute walk in off the road.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
See, look at all these beautiful Maritimers, eh? Everybody's so friendly here. Definitely going to go check out the Bay of Fundy. That's a highlight here.
Yeah, highest tides in the world.
Yes. Here's my stylist. She's here in Canada for 4 months now, from the Ukraine, so... Yes. What a great place to come to, huh? End up in Canada, end up in the Maritimes. Couldn't ask for a better place to arrive. Well, look who's looking fresh! Boy, she did a good job cutting my hair, man. You know, Elena was her name. Yeah, she's from the Ukraine. The other lady beside her in the background, too, as far as I know, is also another Ukrainian refugee. What a tragedy, man. These people didn't want to leave their countries, but, you know, they had to due to the war. And it's, I don't know why in 2022 we're still fighting wars, you know. Like, it should be about love and peace and loving each other and trying to expand the human experience of love and caring and enjoying each other's company and enjoying the beautiful world God made us. But we're still fighting wars. It's not us. It's the elites. These governments are picking on each other, fighting nonsense wars and killing the people. And it's very sad to me to let these people continue to run our countries like this and use us against each other. You know, we all bleed red. All we want is a good life for our families. But yet, things like geopolitics and governments blaming each other and not keeping their nose in their own business, you know, is a very sad thing. I hate war. I mean, this lady here has two kids. Her husband is not allowed to leave the country because he has two kids and he's in 18 to 60. Like, you've just broken a family. What if all of a sudden, you know, this guy, a shell over there, or gets shot by accident and he's not afraid and his kids grow up without a father? Like, this is horrible. It's a very sad thing. That's going to be my rant on this war. I hate war, but I'm very thankful for this first choice haircuts to give these two women... you know, an opportunity to work in Canada, to be a part of Canada and make a living. Nobody wants to leave their country, to be honest with you. Everybody's got a pride for their nationality, right? But it's just an unfortunate thing. But it was very nice. She's a very nice lady. She gave me a beautiful haircut. Of course, you know, she hasn't really done anything here yet. She said all I've been doing is working and going back to my apartment. So, and I can understand that. You're coming here to a new country. You got to set yourself up. You know, I was having a conversation with her. She was telling me her son's in gymnastics and her daughter likes to do a little bit of drama. And she's hoping to get them back into those things for normal life. So, I wish her well. I wish both of them well. I mean... What a place to come if I was again another refugee and placed in the Maritimes. I gotta say, it is an unfortunate situation. that they had to come here due to war, but also on the other side, they are very lucky to have ended up in the Maritimes, especially in New Brunswick, where the people are friendly and caring about each other. This I know from experience, from having friends working in the oil patch with me. A lot of these East Coasters and the Maritimers, or you call them, especially from New Brunswick, are very kind-hearted people if you treat them right, just like any other nationality. So, but yeah, I'm going to take you guys for a little drive. I'm going to go back to my hotel. Going to take a little shower, clean up, change some clothes, you know. And then I got to head out to Shediac. I got a couple more hours here till the old ball and chain shows up. I'm starting to get a little bit hungry as well. So let's drive back to Moncton from Dieppe. I'm going to show you guys the main street. And here we go. Do, 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 do.
Music in the summertime. It doesn't give me any dates though. Oh, it says here every Thursday. Look, musical. Oh, you scan it here and it tells you. Let me check it out. So there's supposed to be live music tonight at a patio fest. I'm opening up the browser. So let's see what this is all about. Just once. Okay, so we got a downtown Moncton here. This is a vile non-profit organization. They got a show going on. The Patio Fest is tonight and is with Alex Madison at Moncton downtown. So they're all over the city. They just give you a bunch of places to go chill out downtown. See, so they got two patios going on tonight. That's a pretty cool, neat. That's a pretty neat thing to see in the city. I've never seen that before. But here's the chest. Gives you the locations of the places where they have the patio parties. Check it out, man. So this is the downtown. It's very beautiful today, man. I'm happy to be here. But there's lots of hotel selections. There's lots of hotel selections downtown. We're at the Hilton again, but you got the Hyatt, you got the Crown Plaza,
And also, if you're gonna be staying down here, it looks like they have their stadium right down center.
Avenir Center.
Tim Horton.
Delta Bolzinger. Bolzinger. Delta.
Yeah. Yeah. I know. A lot of Japanese.
Who's this guy with this hat? Is he something? No. There's a moose. Duncan moose.
How are you today?
Good, and you?
Oh, good. We're happy to be here on the East Coast.
And it's a light profile.
Oh, nice.
Where is Duncan's coast?
Sounds good.
This is a beautiful one.
So we're on St. George Street, Rue St. George in French. We're going to a restaurant called the Black Rabbit. Gonna take some photos for you guys, maybe a video, but I don't know if they allow videos, but we'll see. But for sure, we'll take some photos. The Black Rabbit in Moncton. Check it out.
And because I enjoy candy, I'm gonna finish up with some pulp of beets that I've dehydrated. So it actually adds a little texture to the cocktail as well.
What a way to start off a meal. I'm getting excited already, honey.
That's right. Hey, voila. Please enjoy if you have any questions.
Ready? That is very delicious. Is it a video? Wow, this is very good. It tastes like beet juice. That's all it tastes like, but it's very sweet. There's a little bit of after linger from the liquor. Very nice. Get ready.
Try it. On the other side, we have the foam. We've done it the same way we've done the mise en meringue, foam, but it's actually a sour cream, smoked sour cream, with also a bit of mushroom in there as well. But the turnips, the salad turnips at the top, they're from Bradford Farm. We adore this farm and the vegetables.
Yeah.
We poach it just in a little bit of olive oil, and then also we add fleur de sel and lemon shavings as well.
Oh, wow.
Thank you.
The
wine that you're going to have with this, actually the lines on the menu kind of dictate where the wine stops.
Follow me.
This is from the Languedoc Roussillon by Gérard.
With you, I can be sad. With you, just take my hand and fly up through the dreams. Where the skies are so clear, with you, I wanna stay with you. With you, I love the way that you love me today. Let's run up through the fields where the sun shines and heals. I wanna stay with you. so long.